Barre Wilson, longtime old friend. We probably met in like, what time, when did you start as Realtors? 2000 something.
2005.
No, it had been earlier than that. Because I left in 2006, and it seemed like I knew you a really long time already.
I think I knew you before then, somewhere.
And then we were reunited at Days. And then here we now have come from far and wide to Las Vegas to support our friend Eric and his beautiful wife to open this cardio bar. And then I brought my very best friend, Carrie's sister, who I've known my whole life practically, Wendy, who's a pretty new transplant to Las Vegas. And I think this just kicked your butt, didn't
it? Yeah.
Perfect. Vegas needed this. I don't think there's another cardio bar here.
I don't think there is. But this one really kicks your butt, doesn't it? And I'm telling you, you come a lot. And one, you see an amazing difference, but two, you pick up this routine and it's not that hard, but you keep pushing and you keep, every time you put your leg behind you, stretch everything more and you just, and sometimes I think like, oh God, when is this over? But then I think, I'm just going to commit for these like 8 minutes of this stretching my butt. Because it makes a huge difference. No, it makes a huge difference because I'm kind of naturally chubby, kind of, you know. No, I am. You are.
I never go anywhere with no sleeves.
But anyway, so I don't need to say thank you to you because I didn't bring you here. But thanks for coming.
You know about my blog?
I don't.
This is, well, it's really plank, which is because I had the cookbook Plenty, which is one word. You know that cookbook Plenty? I'm a big cook. But Plenty, it's like a vegetarian cookbook. But I kind of like the one word thing, and so when I just got the cookbook. So when I was naming this, I thought plank, which is a platform for inspired living. But I write about all different things, and different people, if you have something you want to write about, you can write about it. But it depends on what inspires me. Sometimes it's just recipes, and sometimes it's about being a nice person, or parenting, or letting go, or when you're a parent. So if you ever, you should read it, and then if you think of something, you.
I will.
We came out here today because we want to support our great friend and his opening of Cardio Bar.
Yeah, you got to support the people you love, and you know I think there's a common denominator with all of it. It is wellness.
Yes.
Physical, mental health, and wellness. And that's part of this whole thing.
You did that.
I'm living it. I'm living the lifestyle. Yeah.
I know. I've also seen those old Days books where they always had you have your shirt off. Like that was even the show. Wasn't that always a mandatory part? Yeah, let's get him without his shirt on. Nobody had their shirt off more than you.
Funny.
It's funny. It's true. They never asked me. They never asked. And if they do, I'm getting a onesie.
Trust me, they would if they could legally. Ratings would be through the roof.
Oh, liar.
They did. No, seriously. They, I think one of them I was painting.
Yeah.
In my backyard.
Do you even paint?
I do paint.
Okay.
I do paint shirtless, but I'm certainly not going like this, going, holding my breath, flexing, going, okay, here comes the blue.
Or you're like, let me do 10 push-ups really quick. Okay, now I'm ready.
It's not quite that contrived, but I really paint.
Yeah, that's so funny. Well, you know, they had me making my pies, and I was wearing like a Lucy apron and big plastic bangle bracelets, and I was like, I look like this when I'm baking, you know what I mean? So, okay.
I was grilling, too. They had me grilling.
Was your shirt on?
It was on. They don't really talk about it. People go, you signed the book? And they'll go, oh, there you are. They're like, no, not that one. Yes, that one. I'm like, okay.
Yeah, go figure. Anyway, you're the nicest guy, and you're a lot more than your washboard. But anyway, so also another cool thing here is your charity. And I know you and Ari have this incredible charity. She was telling me about it, but I'm a really bad recounter of information. I think I am. So why don't you talk?
Can we break it down for you a little bit?
Would you break it down? Today, the money raised today is going to the charity, which is so cool.
A portion of that goes to Earhart Adventure Camps. And what we do, we empower young teens through outdoor adventure. It's very simple. And what most of the adventures, really, are couched around one of our six C's, which are all character-building virtues and qualities. And I think that's really what speaks to the heart of Earhart, hence the name, is that, look, go have fun. Get outside. But I think there's a generation of kids are missing what it means to persevere, to communicate, to have character, what it means to have critical thinking, compassion. So we work on those things every week, couched around an adventure, and we use the community in the respective city that we're in.
And you do a lot of cities, right?
We do a lot of cities. Right now we're in Idaho, where I'm from Michigan, so we opened up in Detroit. And even in Idaho, it's rural kids, whereas in Detroit, it's urban kids.
Right.
It's a really universal. And also, LA, we're opening. I've talked to some people, investors in Portland, in Atlanta, and then Ari and I went to the Capitol in Sacramento, talk to legislators about how we can implement a program there. So everybody's excited about the idea because essentially you're using the community assets to help build the next generation of kids in that community.
And did you guys come up with this idea? Or was
her
it
brother like? Came up, well actually let me go back, Ari and her brother came up with it in 2007, I know that because this was established in 2007. Because Ari of course always wants to do something. And this is how we sort of came together on the idea. I heard her talking about empowering young kids. I was doing that with people in my own family who were struggling to get over that. That crossroads, which we all go through.
Yeah. But I think anything that gets people off of tablets and phones and away from the computers and the TVs and get them outside and get them doing stuff, and that helps their self-esteem and team building helps in every which way, or what their actions, how it affects other people, like all that stuff that you probably, they learn in your camps.
Yeah, because all of it, I think, to me, most things revolve around a strong sense of self-worth, right?
Absolutely.
Can I teach them how to make great choices in every aspect of their life? Certainly. But at the core of all those choices is a strong sense of self-worth. So if you have that, chances are, we all trip and stumble, of course, that they'll make positive choices. And I told the kids in class, I said, listen, you guys are going to be the future leaders tomorrow. You're going to be sitting up here teaching the next kid this very thing I'm teaching you right now. Mm-hmm. So it's cyclical.
Absolutely.
So it's not just about one kid and me. I said, you guys won't meet me. After this, you know, I'll know you and you know me. But you will be so self-empowered. You yourself will be empowering your kids. I looked at my girl right in the eye. You believe that? And she's just like,
maybe you'll say, though, I guess.
You know, I said, I'm telling you right now, you will be that leader. That's guys awesome. And girls, boys, everybody.
And do you do scholarships?
We do.
Is it all scholarships or not?
In Detroit, it is all scholarships. Because we work at the Outdoor Adventure Center, which is our base camp. And it's an amazing facility. They've taken an old warehouse in downtown Detroit. Community got together, raised $13 million. And basically the DNR is behind it, the Michigan Department of Natural Resources. And they essentially brought the outdoors indoors. So it reflects the outdoors. So in the winter, it's amazing. They've got everything. Deer blinds, quad runners, canoeing, kayaking, fishing, all indoors. And they have a big, huge fish tank with Michigan fish in it. They have a cave and a waterfall.
Jeez.
And then from this like deer blind, it's like Disneyland, but outdoors, a small version of it. So they've been fantastic. And once we talked about Earhart Adventure Camps, Linda Walters, who runs this place, is like, would you bring your camp here? And I was like, tomorrow. So now we did that, and it's really now getting community sponsors and business leaders, whatever city they go into, to get behind it and support it, because really, it sort of is an encyclical. It will give back to the community. And we have a compassion component, a service component, where these kids give back. Like, the Department of Natural Resources has been amazing to us. So we had them cleaning the parks last week. I have a strong affinity for Native American cultures. They were taught about a relationship with the environment through a Native American. So it's really just finding those people.
This has become your new full-time job, I see, right?
I'm 20. You know, you're going to have to edit like this down a lot. But
No. Oh, me too. You have to be passionate about something. It's the greatest thing, isn't it?
Look, you're not. You love what you do. You create. We talk about this even on Sunday.
Yeah, but you got to have other things going on. It comes and goes.
It comes and goes. But what's always sustaining is the fact that you give back to somebody. What's driven me is, look, how can I enrich and inspire other people, even as a character, and as certain as a man, only when it's a human, right?
Oh my God.
An artist and a humanitarian. I want to do it all. I'll do it every day. But that's it. You need more in your life, I think, to find a sense of self-worth.
I agree with you. We can't just be takers.
No.
We gotta give everybody. I mean, that's
the
opportunity.
And this is why you and I are here. People that come out to support things like this that have a passion. This is passionate about health and wellness through just dancing, through cardio. So you're like, that's very on par with who we are as people. So I'm like, I'm there.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. All right, well, we're going to get his website thing and we'll put it up. So you guys
can where now? Arrow-heart.org. Check it out. Go there. You'll see a lot
of it. It's a guy like, now, baby, now.
I am not. Listen, I am a man.
You're all about now.
No, you're more.